In this video, we'll see some advanced features of the message box. For example, if you get a message box, you get multiple buttons on that. Let's say, OK, cancel. Which button will you press and what is the output given? So if you press OK button, what should happen? If you press cancel button, what should happen? And so on. So based on the button you select, you get the answer for that. Let us see that. Now, what I've done is, I'm in the same Excel VBA boxes. Go to developer tab, click on this Visual Basic. I'm in the same module D underscore message box 4. That's a simple macro which is written message box welcome comma 1. So that's the first button style. Let us execute that. If I click on this run button and I'll click on cancel. Yeah, I'll click on this run button. Yeah. So if you see, I've got as welcome and I've got as OK cancel. Now, if I click on OK, nothing happens. Again, if I execute and if I click on cancel button, nothing happens because I have not asked my macros to do anything on that. Let us see if I click on OK, what happens? If I click on cancel, what is the output? So I'll just type here something as whatever output I'm getting, either OK or cancel, that I want to capture in some variable. So that variable, let's say I'll type as A. So I'll type A equal to, that's it. So A equal to message box welcome comma 1. If I type OK, that will be stored into A variable. If I type cancel, that will be stored in the that variable, A variable. But when I scroll down, it says expected end of the statement. There's some mistake here. So what is the mistake? I'll tell you. When you type a function here and you want the output of that function, always write in the brackets. So message box is an inbuilt function by Microsoft. So message box welcome, and now it is working fine. If you remove this brackets, it will throw an error message, and I'll type as message box A. Very simple. What I've done is the output I'll get from this message box I'll store in the A variable I want to display. Let us see that. If I click on this run button, now welcome. If I click on OK button, the value of OK button will go in the A variable. Click on OK and A variable will be displayed. So it is 1. So OK means 1. Again, if I execute, I'll click on this run button. Now I'll not click on OK, I'll click on cancel button. So it says if you click on cancel button, the value of cancel button is how much? It is 2. So I'll click on OK. So message box A. So value of OK button is 1, cancel button is 2. Let us try some more here. Now I'll change the button style. Button style for 2. Let us see now. I'll click on run button. It is abort, retry, cancel. If I click on abort, the value of abort is how much? It is 3. I'll click on OK. Now I'll click on this run again. If I click on this retry button, what is the value of retry? It is how much? It is 4. Click on OK. Again, if I click on this run button, if I click on this ignore, the value of ignore button is 5. Right? I hope you're getting it. So even the message box, which is giving the output, OK, cancel, abort, retry, they have some button values. Based on the button values, you can define something, you can do something. Let us see that. I'll just take it back as 1. Okay. Now, you know, I have the two outputs, either 1 or either 2. That is OK 1 and cancel is 2. Now, I'll put a if else condition here. If A equal to 1, then message box OK button was pressed. I hope you're able to understand because if condition we have done there. Else message box cancel button was pressed, end if, that's it. Now if you observe, if the value of OK button is 1, if A equal to 1, then this will be displayed, OK button was pressed. If the value of this A equal to 2, then this will be displayed, cancel button was pressed, and finally end if. Let us see now. So if I execute this, if I click on OK button, OK, and if you see 1 is displayed and OK button was pressed. So it is going in the if condition. I'll click on OK. Now if I click on this run button, click on cancel, the value is 2. Now it will go in the else condition, and if you see cancel button was pressed. So this way you can keep on utilizing the output from the message box and you can use in the coding purpose itself, right? So if you want, once again we'll execute. I'll click on step into. And if I click on OK, message box, the value of A is how much it is? Now it is 1. Okay, I'll just show you here. Yeah, if I keep my cursor, you see the value of A equal to 1. And if I click on step into, and now if you see it came to this particular line, step into, okay, and finally end if, right? So I hope you're able to understand how we can get the output from a message box, utilize it using if else condition. You can use different statements, select statement, or you can use for loop, if loop, and so if condition itself. I hope you have understood, and that's all for this video.